SchoolFreeware's QBasic tutorial series, tutorial 4, variables and data types. Variables hold data in memory, are assigned a data type, the data can change throughout the program's operation, and the data must be the same data type as assigned to the variable. These are the data types found within QBasic 1.1 and QB64. String, which is basically text and characters, the integer, which is a non-floating point data type. The long data type can hold a larger number than the integer. We also have the single, which is a floating point data type, and the double, which can hold a larger number than the single data type. Also, please note that QBasic 1.1 may have a problem with computations involving the double data types, which I will show in just a moment. Within QB64, you can also use these data types. These are both 64-bit data types for the integer and the float. For a list of data types found within QB64, please see the website listed at the bottom of the slide. All code can be downloaded at schoolfreeware.com, and this tutorial will show QB64 running on Windows 7 and also QBasic 1.1 running in DOSBox on Windows 7. I'll start off by showing the error within QBasic 1.1 using the double data type. Now let's start by making a variable called x, dim x as double. I'll clear the screen and I'll set x to equal 3.2 and I'll print x on the screen. Go ahead, run, start. We get 3.2 and a bunch of other numbers. If I were to change the value of x to 3.6, start and run, I don't get 3.6, but I get something close to 3.6. If I multiply 3.6 by 10, I expect 36. Instead, I get 35.999. 3.6 times 1,000. Once again, the number is not correct. This does not happen within QB64, but I would like to point out that on some computers in some situations, the double data type within QBasic 1.1 is not completely accurate. I'll start with the old school way of making variables. First of all, I'll start with clearing the screen. I'll make a variable called header. Header will be a string, so I'll put a dollar sign. And I'll make header equal to, this is an example program. I'll create another variable called num1 as an integer. Set num1 to equal 5. Num2 will also be an integer. Num2 will equal 6. Num3 is a long integer, 45,000. Num4, also a long integer, 54,000. Num5, single, 4.5. Num6, also a single, 6.75. Num7 will be a double data type, 56,000.25. And finally, num8 will be a double data type equal to 89,034. I'll print the header. Then I'll print some calculations. Num1 plus num2 plus num3. Print num6 divided by num5. Print num8 plus num2. Last one, print num4 divided by num1. Okay, I'll go ahead and run. And this is the output. Here's the other way of declaring variables. This is also the way Visual Basic works with variables. So I'll start off by declaring dim. Now let's make num1 as an integer. Num2 is going to be declared as a long. Dim num3 as a single. We declare num4 as a double, and we'll declare header as a string. Okay, I'll go ahead and clear the screen. Header is equal to, this is another example. Num1 will be equal to 5. Num2 is equal to 56,000. Num3 is 45.635. Num4, make that 66,000.5634. And I'll go ahead and print the header. And print will make this easy. Num1 plus num2 plus num3 plus num4. Go ahead, run.